Going on, Clashers. This is DJ Clan Smasher, and today I'm bringing you an exciting episode: White Temple versus Darc Dawning. It was a real close match. Well, the score, it kind of, you know, seems like it's pretty far fetched, but there was a few 11v11s that they attempted. One of them was a 1-star, and they didn't get an extra star on the 10v11, so that's where we had them. But we did manage to get an 11v11. And guys, this was a very important war. It could have either gone good or bad, in the sense that if we didn't win, there would have been a good chance that we might have not made it to playoffs, but this win for sure secured the playoffs. So it was very important for us to go in our A game, and as you can see, we did a pretty good job. We got two of the 10v11s, one of the 10v10s, and one of the 11v11s. Our 9v9 game wasn't too hot, but we did a great job. We got a 67%, so 14 out of 21, which enabled us to get at least 7 scouts. So good stuff there by White Temple. I did get a chance to get into it with my Town Hall 9. My 10 was in CWL, so I couldn't use it. But, you know, very excited for the playoffs. So anyways, as you can see, Trav here is using this Town Hall 9 Dragon Hit, and he's been killing it lately. He actually did a great job here with his accounts. He got a 10v11, he got a few 10v10s, he got a few 10v11s, he got some great 9v9s, and pretty much was the one who got the 10v11s, the only two 10v11s that we had. So good stuff there by Trav, and, you know, pretty much leading the war for the most part, you know, making sure that everyone knows what's going on, checking up on the accounts and everything, and making sure that everyone's good with the plan. So great stuff there by Trav. Big props to him. And big props to White Temple in general. We've been killing it. We've been doing a great job working as a team, getting those 9v9s in, getting some great scouts, and doing our best with 10v10s. We were unfortunate and got a few high percentage 2-stars. As with Darc Dawning, they also had a few upsets as far as in 11v11. They almost 3-starred one of our 11s. They got a 98% 2-star. I believe it was a time fail. Can't remember the exact details, but they didn't get the 3-star. It was very close. So good stuff by them. And then for one of their 11v11s, they actually only got a star on the hit. So that's where the star differential came into play. But anyways, this is Alex here showing us an awesome hit. Did a hog attack and pretty much killed it here. Send a giant in just to kind of tank a little bit, and then after that sends in a loon to try to take care of that Tesla. If he would have sent it a little bit sooner, a few less hogs would have gone in sprung trap, but you know, he still killed it. A lot of hogs to clean up, so great job there by Alex getting the job done and getting that 9v9. So I'll be showing you another, well, I mean, actually I'll be showing you the 10v10 that we got, and then the 11v11. I'm not going to show the 10v11s because we did attempt a lot, so it wasn't really a fresh 10v11 hit, so I'm not going to be showing those, but I'll be showing the 10v10 and the 11v11, which will be coming up here soon. And stay tuned for more content for sure. I'll be posting some more recaps. One of them's going to be by Jedi Network. They had a recent no dip league match, or no dip match. And I'm also going to be posting the MLCW playoffs, so those recaps. And of course, I'll be posting CWO content for Elite Gaming, so that's the CWO invite. So stay tuned for that as well. And if you haven't subscribed, definitely subscribe. Hit the notification button. That way you know when I post those videos. Sometimes it might take a little while longer, but I try to get them done in the weekend if possible. Just gets a little hectic when you're actually, you know, part of the team, and it's kind of hard to make the videos if you're in there doing that, and you know, busy with other things as well. So anyways, so Gomez, he's actually been a great addition to the clan for White Temple. Been killing it with the 10v10s. He's one of our top 10v10 hitters, and as you can see, he did a wonderful job here taking down the wizard towers, getting rid of these defenses, and the queen coming in here, getting the last wizard tower taken care of, and Gomez gets the 3-star. He did get a 3-star this time. He is very close to 3 stars a lot of the times. Gets like super high 90%, you know, a miss here or there, but for the most part has been a very solid player. So great job there by Gomez, and big props to him for helping us out here, you know, being a great addition to the clan. So now let's go ahead and show you Durjoy's attack. This is going to be an 11v11 attempt. We did attempt a 10v11 for this hit. We're having a hard time with this specific base. So Durjoy decided to go for an 11v11 with a little bit of planning and, you know, coming up with some great plans. I wasn't sure if he was actually planning on breaking in specifically there, but he did a great job of getting all of this taken care of. Sends in a rage spell to keep the queen alive, takes care of the heroes, and then had to use a queen ability because the queen was looking a little down there. And now starts the bow witch attack. So jump right there, another jump straight into the core. I was a little afraid that the boulders would walk around like going to the bottom, but the good thing is that they split pretty well. So great job there by Durjoy coming up with this awesome plan and getting this solid 3-star. As you can see, the queen stayed alive for the most part and then finally did die off. These boulders were able to manage to take care of that inferno. Some of them took a hit with the big bombs there. But the good thing is that this healer is doing some good work. Starts going down, kind of helps the Grand Warden stay alive a little bit longer, but did get sniped by the Sam. And then after that, these boulders are going to clean up and take care of the rest of the base to get the 3-stars. So anyways, guys, thanks again for tuning in. This is DJ Clan Smasher, and don't forget to keep calm and clash on. And I'll see you guys in the next episode.